morning. It's 7 o'clock. Excuse me, these are my first words of the day. I just woke up. And Blair's Wild made some coffee. Cheers. Those of you who follow me or know me in general know that I love coffee. Coffee is like one of my favorite times of the day. I'm such a morning person. I like waking up like 2 or 3 hours before I have to do or be anywhere, just so that I have time to relax and have my coffee and maybe watch a TV show, maybe read. Love watching the Today Show, but I don't pay for cable in New York and I'm ratchet, so I always watch the day before. So I watched the Today Show from yesterday. But it's still the news and it still gets me off, so it's fine. Today, I just wanted to show you kind of what a day in the life for me in New York is. It changes every day with my job. Like, sometimes I'll be working, sometimes I'll have castings and appointments, and today I have 2 castings, and one is at 9 a.m., so normally I will wake up and have coffee and then go work out because there's nothing better than working out on a caffeine high. And I'm like such a morning person. I love starting my day working out and just getting my body moving, that serotonin moving, those serotonin levels up. Excuse me, I'm like, literally I haven't had enough coffee yet. A couple appointments today and then I'll work out later with my trainer, which you guys will see. I just started school again yesterday and I'm taking 4 classes this semester, so it'll be a busy day, but I'm excited. I love being busy. I feel like I thrive more being busy than not and having too much time to think and driving myself crazy. Just wanted to show you guys what a day in New York could look like for me. Definitely someone who thrives on having a schedule and like certain things to do. I make a schedule for myself as much as possible, even though work-wise it changes every day. So yeah, this is my day today. Also, those glasses are blue light glasses. I love them. I wear them whenever it's like kind of dark in a room or outside and I'm watching a screen because I'm watching a TV show right now as I wake up. I found that they actually help a lot when I'm trying to fall asleep. Like, if I don't wear them, I really do notice that the blue light from the screen, because I like, oh, I lit a candle this morning and look at that.
I'm partying again, oh Jesus.
Also, wait, let me just show you my candle because I love it. I got it in Texas with one of my best friends, Alyssa, at like this little street market, and it's in a mug and it says like boss. And I was like, that's a good candle to look at every morning and light. Anyway, blue light glasses make a difference for me. I love them. I will tag these below. They're from a brand called Pixel. Me and my husband discovered them and we literally don't watch screens without them now. Okay, so I need to make my hair look better for this casting. I don't want to shower. And it's really funny because like, don't do my hair and I always let it air dry. And my mom came to visit me a little bit ago and she was like, do you have a hair dryer? I was like, no. Like, I never do anything to my hair. I don't even have a freaking hair dryer. I'm like the worst girl. So she bought one to have here and I'm gonna use it today. Oh my God. Pardon me. Oh my gosh, I'm so tired. Okay, let's see if I use this correctly.
Sometimes I feel like I just wanna go back to my old ways. You're telling me I'm silly, it's no fun. In the old days, I'm such a romantic.
This isn't too bad. I just can't look like I just woke up, you know? Since I'm selling myself. Okay. I keep dropping things. I love that I think I'm funny because I'm really not.
Something real, it's just how we feel. We
will never guess what just happened. I, like the dumb hoe that I am, dropped my phone right down that little crack. I had to take apart my sink and break it open and get into there to get it. The kinds of things that happen to me. It took me an hour. There's shit all over the bathroom floor. I just can't. Like, thank God for my roommate that came and saved me.
To the rescue.
Lord help me. Jesus, take the wheel. I'm on my way to my castle right now with my book. I just can't believe what happened this morning. Like, that shit, I'm not gonna let it ruin my day, but oh my God, what the frick? Only 20 blocks away, so I'm gonna walk to it. Embrace the cold. It's actually not too bad today. It's still in the 40s, which is a little scary. Nice that it's warm, but it's also scary because global warming. So this amazing man just asked me to take his photo on the street next to this billboard of like these two guys in black and white, and I was like, yeah, sure, because I saw him try and take a selfie with it and he like couldn't get it, and I was like, yeah, sure, I'll take the photo for you. I like get the phone and all of a sudden he just starts fucking working it. Like, he's on the corner, like stretching his leg out, putting his arm up. He's like, and I was like, just made my day. Yes, like, and I was like, work! It was so funny, but that's one thing I love about New York is you never know what's gonna happen on the streets. To my casting right now, and I just had to show me the tall girl props. Like, my head is hitting the staircase. We just finished casting number two, and this is trying to come out. And I'm not looking when I cross the road. Probably shouldn't do that. Now I'm going to go home, drop off this fat ass book and pick up my laptop and go to a cafe and do homework before I train this afternoon. It's a super exciting day. Before I go study at the cafe that I'm gonna go to, make a little overnight oat situation, but just not let it sit overnight and just wait till I get to the cafe to eat it, because I haven't been able to eat yet today because I've been running around like crazy. So I will show you what I put into this one. Tablespoon of chia seeds. That was 1/3 cup of these rolled oat. I always add a little bit of salt because that brings out the flavor. And a lot of cinnamon because I love cinnamon. And it's really nice in the cold because it's just really good for circulation. This is the one I'm using right now. But it's good for circulation. It keeps you warm in the cold. And then for the liquid that I put in the oats, I normally will do half almond milk or whatever kind of nut milk I have. I also love macadamia, but I can't find it in New York yet. This is actually 1/3 cup because I only did 1/3 cup of oats. So I'll do 1/3 cup of almond milk and then 1/3 cup of water. And I like making it in these little jars because it's like super easy to just take on the go. So you just shake it like a fully water jar and mix it all up, and then it'll slowly solidify because the chia seeds will kind of like soak in the milk. That's my roommate. The chia seeds will soak up the milk, and I actually learned to use psyllium husk, which is basically straight fiber. I don't have any. I ran out, so normally I put a tablespoon of that in there at Mahina Garcia. I will put her stuff below, but she kind of gave this recipe to me, and the psyllium husk like really makes it solidify, so I don't even know if this shit will really solidify, but it's fine. I cut up some fresh strawberries, and I'm going to top it with like, what is that, 1/3 cup or 1/2 cup of fresh straws, and that is that. So this is the finished product. It has the strawberries in it, and hopefully it's like already starting to solidify a little bit, so should be good by the time I get to the cafe. I just like to make my own and bring my own stuff because a lot of the time when they have overnight oats and things like that at cafes, there's like lots of sugar in it. It's high in sugar. And then I always like to bring this, which is a plastic-free Hawaii. Like to go pack, and it has a metal straw, chopsticks, a spoon, knife, and a fork. And I just bring it so I don't have to use plastic stuff wherever I go. So yeah. Okay, so I just got back from studying for like 2.5 hours and I felt really awkward pulling out my oatmeal. Because I was like, the only seat available was near where they make everything so they could see me. And I was like, I don't want to be disrespectful and pull out my oatmeal. And then I had a coffee and then I was like reading and 2.5 hours went by. And I still haven't eaten my oatmeal. So I was like, holy shit, I'm hungry. So I came home and it didn't fully absorb because I need psyllium husk and I didn't even get it on my way home because I'm hungry. So I am feeling like a little something chocolatey though, so I'm gonna add some cacao powder. This also gives you energy since I'm gonna work out in like 1.5 hours with my trainer. Share with you that I'm gonna add like a tablespoon of cacao powder and see how it tastes. Okay, I added cacao and we'll see how this tastes. It smells incredible. Taste it. Oh, honey, I'm gonna be ready for that workout. Bam. I had a double shot of espresso while I was working out. I can't even talk, working my brain out. So I'm gonna share with you guys a secret of mine that I'm not very proud of, but here it is. As I was training for the VS show, I worked out a lot and I also used this baby. It's an ab belt and it has shock things on it and it like shocks your abs to turn them on and like stimulates them. And so I like to wear it when I do cardio because I'll be like running on the treadmill or doing sprints and it like activates my abs and turns them on. I'm gonna show you how it works, honey, to get those abs. It doesn't give you abs. You obviously have to like have a clean diet, but maybe it can help. This, and you peel off the little things and they're like sticky. So this is what it looks like. I'm really showing you into my life and all my secrets. Working out in the evening is normally a pain in the ass for me because I'm such a morning person and I'm like on my coffee high in the morning, like ready to go. And normally by like 4 o'clock, I'm completely dead. I had double espresso shot and it's keeping me going. So, and my oatmeal. So I'm super excited to work out with my trainer right now and introduce him to you. So I made it to my workout at 4:30 because he couldn't do it earlier. My best trainer ever, Andrew. Andrew Page, I'll link him below.
And I wore my shirt.
I know, he wore a collared shirt. I was like, whoa, turn it up.
But if this brings you just a little closer to those men who are going into the hottest spots, you to do a better job.
We're super tight. Good, hold it. 6, 5, stay on it. 4, 3, good, 2, One. Good.
Better job.
Part two of three, two, one.
I'm scared.
Go, don't die. Not bad. Last one. All posterior chain. Nice job. Good and relax. Last one. Yeah, no, you got it. 45 seconds off. The rest of the minute, you take the rest of the minute off. A lot of juice. Oh, look, it's a friend.
The hottest spots.
Breathe. There we go.
I just finished my workout and it was so gnarly. Actually, not just. I finished it a little bit ago, but I had to walk it off because I'm literally shaking and my legs are so tired. That was crazy. But I'm gonna go get some salmon for protein and put it on a yummy salad because your girl is hungry and that was an early workout. Andrew, you crushed me. I feel like I'm in shape, and then when I do one of his workouts, I'm not in shape anymore. Like, I don't know what happens. It's crazy. But yes, I'm gonna go get some salmon and show you what I do with it. I just got home and I'm going to make a salad and ended up getting some shrimp. So, very excited about that because your girl's hungry. And I'm drinking a lot of water because I worked out today and I just did a hard workout, but I like to be a little extra. I like to got some green kombucha and I try to drink like half of these a day, like not a whole one because it does have sugar in it, but it's in a wine glass, baby. Cheers to Tuesday.
It gets past cute weird.
It gets weird. Okay, so I'm going to make a sauce that I always make to dip things in. I'm getting drunk off kombucha in here. Anyways, it's like this weird mustard sauce that I love making. It tastes like honey mustard. I eat some weird shit. Like, you can ask my husband, you can ask my roommate. I make some really weird food combinations. It's just how I roll. So I'm gonna show you what I put in this abnormally good but weird sauce combination. I'm gonna make some sauce up in here. Okay, so what goes in this bowl? Mustard. I put in a big old squeeze of yellow mustard, a little dash of coconut aminos, a little dash of apple cider vinegar, a little dash of sriracha if I want some heat, which I like to eat the heat, and like a packet of stevia so that it tastes like honey mustard. It sounds weird, but just give it a try. Give it a shot. At Stephanie Buttermore, you taught me about this sauce probably like a year ago. I'm very into it, so I'm gonna use it for my salad. Cause I don't like putting dressing on my salad. I like having it on the side, and then I'll take bites without dressing, and then I'll put bites. But yeah, that's the sitch. I'll show you what it looks like when it's done. This is what it looks like. It's like, look, it doesn't look that good, but I promise you it's pretty good. Recipe in below, and you can tweak it to what you like. I tweaked it a little bit from what Stephanie first put. Yeah, I love it. So this is my dinner. We have greens, shrimp on the side. I put it on top, and my weird mustard sauce with some kombucha and of course water. As you can tell, I'm still in my workout outfit. I'm weird and I kind of like to sit in my sweat for a second. I know it probably is gross, but I'm hungry and I want to eat. So yeah, this is the situation and I'll let you know how it goes. To break into this morning, and now I'm screwing the door back on because I had to take the doors off in order to get this off. It was the whole situation. I can really tell that happened. I'm actually very impressed. Well, I shouldn't be impressed because I just like, why does this shit happen to me? Why does it happen to me? I don't understand. I'm so clumsy. Yes, that's what I'm doing after dinner tonight, which normally I would just relax and take this as my time to like de-stress and maybe meditate, but no. Now I'm doing this. So I just got out of the shower and I'm going to make some roasted dandelion root tea before I go to sleep. I ate like a whole bag of green beans that I didn't film. I just put them in the oven with nothing and baked them, and they always taste amazing. So now I'm gonna make some of this. I have to shoot digitals tomorrow. Roasted dandelion root just is good for like, it says stimulates the liver and supports healthy digestion on the box. But for me, it's like a deep bloat. Like I just feel in the morning after drinking it. Whole thing that I tell myself, but I really like it, so I'm gonna make a cup of that with my fun little boiler here. And yeah, probably just watch some TV and go to sleep because I'm pretty tired. Our night has took a turn for the worse. We just saw a fucking mouse in our apartment! Our reaction. We literally both screamed and ran. And it's a tiny little baby mouse. Like, it's actually really cute, but like, no.
Okay. All right.
This is very stressful. Bait it with Brie. She has Brie cheese. We can catch it.
Brie. I hope it prefers Brie. Oh my god. Okay.
This has never happened to me before, ever. I'm scared.
You know where it is now. Because maybe however it got in, it went back.
It ran down behind the stove. Maybe there's like something that comes up by the stove, like the gas or something.
Yeah, like gaping holes or like gas connections in water, and there's nothing back here. So I don't think it can get under the fridge. I think it's coming from the stove. It couldn't have come from the bathroom. It kept running from there.
Man, I am tired. 8:30. Can't wait to get into bed. I don't know why I have these on. Maybe could I help cute in them? when I talk to my husband while I'm brushing my teeth, he's like, what? Like, what do you say? Well, you know what I'm saying. Do you? But it's pearly white. So clean. Okay, I'm going to bed now. Guys, I'm so tired from filming all day, and it was kind of a big day. And I totally forgot to do an outro. Oh, come on, Caitlin, way to be a YouTuber. I just wanted to say thank you for watching. Like and subscribe. I look like a crazy person. I'm sorry you have to see me like this. But yeah, thank you for watching. Like and subscribe. I hope that you like this. And I'd love to hear what you guys want to see next. So yeah, thanks for following and subscribe. Okay, bye.